Thank you. Sergeant Major represents you. The only way I can do that is get out and get face to face with you all, okay? For you all to be totally honest with me. So when I say here in just a couple minutes, I want to hear your concerns and your questions. Do not stand there looking like a knot on the log. Because if you do, you send the message that everything is great. Everything is perfect and there's no problem. So when I go back, the chief of staff of the Army says, Sergeant Major says, what's the soldiers thinking? Train's thing out there, right? Everything must be good to go. Francis didn't say anything. He looked like everything is good to go. It's getting down to you. But one of the things that bothers me, and you all have learned that in the time that you've been here, information, getting information out is essential. I keep telling people as I travel around, do not filter the information, especially what has to do with the bill down there. It sets me when I found out that people say, well, I'm not sure they didn't need to know that and so forth. Yes, you do. You need to know it. The fellow soldiers need to know it so you can make good, sound decisions. There's a lot of people who thought that we were throwing people out of the Army. How many of you think we're throwing people out of the Army? Some of you really believe that, right? Let me tell you, part of the bill down, right? Let me tell you, as part of the bill down, the only people we have put out involuntarily in the United States Army are sergeants majors. We picked a group of sergeants majors between 25 years of service and 28 years of service, and we told them they had to leave. They hadn't done anything wrong, we just told them we had to open up the top for the continued promotion that we're going down. Other than that, by the way, QMP, Qualitative Management Program, does not count. That is not part of the build-down program. The QMP has been around since 1972, and it will be around to 2002, very far beyond, not part of the build-down. The rest of the people have, unless we court-martial somebody or something. Now, they changed the retention control point also, so some people would leave early. But they were all vested for retirement. Didn't hurt anybody as far as retirement. You may have had to leave a couple of years early. But that was also so that all of you that are now coming in, that are our future senior non-commissioned officers, have the opportunity to continue to move up as we fell down. If we didn't do that, you all would get tired and you'd get out of us. We don't want to do that. We want to continue to have promotions, even though we're building down our army. Okay? By the way, congratulations to all of you for being selected for this. But I'm telling you, it is essential. By the way, how do you like BLDC? Interesting course. That can mean a lot of things, right? Right? Is it a positive kind of thing? And what do you think about this kind of thing for having different services attend the leadership course? You think it's a positive thing? You know, we're even considering bringing over Marine instructors over here. That should add, show the different services working together, because everything we're going to do from now on is going to be joint service. It's going to be all, you know, you got the one Army, the Reserve, the National Guard, and the Reserves. Like I tell a lot of people, if you don't believe in that, especially at your young age, if you don't believe in that, get the hell out. I'm telling you, honestly. Our Army is one Army. All of those people working together. We've got to help one another be the very best we can. Because we cannot go to a desert storm without the active component, the reserve component, the National Guard. Why? Not only that, but there are elements, there are services that are provided only by the National Guard and Reserve. They're the only ones that have those elements. We don't keep them on active duty all the time. Really only need them when we deploy to something like Desert Storm. But they're proficient in those things. You gotta think, one Army moves everybody, you got the joint services, we gotta get along with the other services. More and more we're gonna combine how we train. We're gonna train together, JRTC. How many of you gone to JRTC? JRTC is becoming a joint, more and more a joint exercise. People that are getting ready to go up there in just a couple of weeks, about a week now, last iteration that goes through Arkansas there, Fort Chaffee, right? And I got to tell you, every element of all military services is going to play a major part. That is going to be something to see. That's what it's all about. interim policy. The interim policy says the people that are now coming into the Army are no longer asked a question. No little questionnaire presented to me at this time. Somewhere around 80% of all the people I've ever talked to were adamant about keeping the band in place. There's approximately 20% that either say lift the band or it doesn't matter to them, because as long as they do the job, it's over. So we have to make sure that the entire situation is discussed. We have to present it, we have to give you all an opportunity to present it, or at least the soldiers in the field. We're going to do that. The only people that are going to be able to convince the president not to totally lift that ban will be Congress. And that's the reason everybody, they're trying to get as much information as possible. People from both sides of the issue. However, if they do lift the ban, we already have a team, which is really what your question is, we already have a team that is looking into all of the things that we'll be affected by. And let me tell you, there's a difference. I did not realize, it's really until I went out talking to a bunch of soldiers and everything, and different questions they were asked about living in quarters, living in the village, some of the things you're talking about. I've even had soldiers that have asked me, will we be given the option of getting out, since you're changing the environment in which I have just been through. We're even looking at that. I can tell you the likelihood is very slim, because not that we wouldn't want to try to do it, but you can talk about readiness. And so we will do what we have to do if the band is lifted. We will not allow lifting of the band to in any way affect that, to affect the possibility of losing people's lives. We are not going to do anything that's going to jeopardize. We will make the rules work. Got to do it this time. How does everybody feel?
Train by example!
There you go. Fall in! Thank you very much.